Hi Puzzlers, Dario here. It has been more than a month since I last uploaded a video, and before I start with the actual video I want to thank everybody for their patience throughout that time. I am still studying for my last exam, but raced all the time I could afford to at least finish this one puzzle that I've come up with 4 weeks ago. Basically, this puzzle is based on an idea by Maker's Muse, who uploaded a video showing how to design a print-and-play sliding puzzle. As I always wanted to design a bandaged 15 puzzle, I thought I'd try it using this print-and-place approach. So, as a first step, I started drawing my idea on a piece of paper. I had a rough idea of how the puzzle should look like later on, but had to experiment a bit before finding the optimal size and position of the bandaged pieces. At first, I wanted to go for a 5x5 grid, but eventually reduced it to a 4x4 one to make things easier and start off with a realistic project. I used small pieces of paper to simulate the pattern that I had thought of to make sure that it actually could be scrambled. Then I went on with the design and on shape. That turned out to be easier than I had thought. Starting with a non-bandaged 4x4 grid, I designed the pieces using just one cutting surface that I duplicated using a linear pattern. Then I started to work on each piece individually by adding clearances and fillets to make the puzzle printable as just one piece. I also added a fancy name tag just like I did on the Infinity Loop puzzle. In this section view you can see the gaps between the pieces. Those are supposed to prevent the pieces from sticking together during the print. Last but not least, I rendered the stickers which I wanted to look like domino bricks. Once all that planning was done, I sent the file to Nico, who printed it for me. In the meantime, I prepared the stickers using my vinyl cutting machine. The puzzle turned out awesome and was fully functional without a lot of post-processing, so all that was left to do was to apply the stickers to it. Unfortunately, I didn't have access to paint, which meant that I was not able to color the name tag. For this video, I decided to put on some stickers instead, which turned out terrible, as they just didn't want to stick to the small surfaces. So later on, I want to permanently color the name using silver paint. Still, for now, I'm quite happy of how this puzzle turned out. And here it is. The domino puzzle is finished. The way I designed this, this is a puzzle consisting of 4 dominoes, which are bandaged 2x1 sliding pieces, as well as 6 smaller square pieces, of which 3 have a number on them as well. Just like in the well-known domino game, the object of this puzzle is to arrange the pieces in a way that numbers next to each other match up. Here you can see the solved state. There are 4 fours in the middle, as well as 2 ones, 2 threes and 2 fives. Now, to scramble the puzzle, you can slide pieces around like this. At first the puzzle seems to be too bandaged to even scramble it, but the hole, which has the size of 2 little squares, allows you to always move either one of the big pieces or 2 of the small ones. The puzzle is designed in a way that you can grab pieces from both sides, but holding the camera in my left hand, I found it easier to just put it down on a table while making moves. Now I'm scrambling the puzzle to show you how it looks while it is scrambled. I already solved this puzzle, but decided not to add the solve to this video to keep it nice and short. If you're interested in seeing the solve, I can upload a separate video about me solving this puzzle. All in all, I have to say that I'm very proud of this idea and happy about how it turned out. This puzzle is super fun to play around with and completely different to other puzzles in my collection. Considering that this is a print-and-place design, the puzzle moves very well. In some positions it seems to be a bit loose, but pieces can't fall out anyways. I'm a bit disappointed about those stupid letter stickers up here which just keep sticking to my hands instead of the puzzle, but that's something I'll take care of once I'm done with the exams. For now, I hope you enjoyed today's video and I'm looking forward to your comments regarding this puzzle. Have a nice day, bye!